Good morning, dear kids. In English grammar subject, today we are starting a new topic that name is pronouns. In earlier classes, you already aware about pronouns. Pronoun is a word which can be used instead of noun. It is a one type of word which used for in the place of name, place and things. Okay? So here a pronoun is a word which used instead of a noun. For example, Jay is a good boy. Jay help his parents. So here in pronoun, we will avoid the extra things. We will avoid the repeating things. For example, here Jay name is repeating again and again. So on the replace of Jay name, we using a pronoun. So which type of pronoun we using here? You can see here, Jay is a good boy. He helps his parents. So here we use he pronoun, right? So pronoun is a word which used instead of a noun. Got it? Now there are lots of kinds of pronoun, but in related to your class, in fourth class you have to study only a one type of pronoun, and that name is personal pronoun. So now this personal pronoun are divided into three categories. First one is subject pronoun, then second one is objective pronoun, and the third one is possessive pronoun. Okay, so now we discussing this all pronoun in detail. First one is subjective pronoun. So what is subjective pronoun? Subjective pronoun is a pronoun which is used on the place of subject. Okay, so first we must be know about the subject. Okay, without subject you cannot find or replace this pronoun. For example, if I gave you one example, the woman is rich. So in this sentence, the woman is a subject. The woman is a subject. They're talking about woman. Here they're talking about woman. So we replace by that, that is she. Okay? She is a rich. Got it? Now in subjective pronoun, there are three types of person. First person is a person. The person is speaking. Okay? And second person is a person. The person is spoken to. Okay, and the third person is a person, the person spoken of. Okay, if the person is speaking and it is in a single form, so we will apply the pronoun I. First person is talking and it is in a plural form, so here we apply we. Similarly, in a second person is a spoken to. Okay, so here is a second person is a single form, then we apply you, and it is also in plural form, we applying a you pronoun. Okay, if we talking about any third person in subjective pronoun, so we'll use the pronoun like he, she, it. He is used for boy, she used for a girl, and it used for a bird, animal, any type of non-living things. Okay, so it is in a single form, then we will use he, she, it, and if it is in a plural form, then we will apply they. Okay, for example, here you can see there is some example of subjective pronoun. We don't want to go there. Here the subject is we. Here they're talking about we. So we is a pronoun. Here we replace the subject with we, because here talking about we. So here we cannot be put each name. So simply we will replace this by a pronoun. Here they're talking about we. We means plural. Plural, and it is talking about we means first person, we plural first person, so we applying we. Then if I give you one example, tiger is a wild animal. So which pronoun you are replace this tiger? We replace this tiger by it, because we already know that it is only used for animals, birds and any type of things. Okay, so here we will replace tiger by it, because in subjective pronoun we replace subject by it. So here tiger is a wild animal, so tiger is a subject, so we replace tiger by it. Okay, so got it about subjective pronoun. Now the second one is objective pronoun. It is also in a similar way of subjective pronoun, but here we only change the position by object. Means here we only change the pronoun on the place of object. Okay, so objective pronoun is a pronoun that can be used on the place of object. Okay. For example, if I told you a cow gives milk. So what is the object here? Milk. Milk is a object. So we replace this milk. If I give one more example, a writer writes books. So here a writer is a subject, writes is a verb, and the books is a object. So we replace the object. Okay, we will replace object. Okay, so whatever we replace object with any word, that is called a objective pronoun. Okay, so which pronoun are used in objective pronoun? You can see here, if talking about first person, then we will use me, us. If we talking about second person, then we will use you, you. If we talking about third person, then it is him, her, and it. Okay, well, here is some example objective pronoun. Does Bella speak English? So please convert this in an objective pronoun. Yes, Bella speak it. Why we apply it? Because here they're talking about English subject. It is a one type of thing. It is one type of things. And it is a third person. We're talking about any third person. So we apply here it. Does Dr. Modi know that man? So yes, Dr. Modi knows him. Why we applying here him? Because here we're talking about that man, means third person. And we know that in third person, and it is in a single form, or it is a boy, then we apply him. Then we apply him pronoun, okay? Now, the last one is a possessive pronoun. Possessive pronoun is a pronoun which is used for our ownership. It is used for our ownership. It is so the attachment with any things. So it is so ownership, right? My, your, his, her, its, our, your, their, right? It is so some attachment with other things, okay? So for example here, this is my book. So here our ownership on this book. So here we apply possessive pronoun. This is my book. This is our college. This is our school. That is your table. That is your bike. This is your cycle. So this is all are called a possessive pronoun. Okay, so now you have to read this all the pronouns collectively: subjective, objective, and possessive. And also here I gave you one example. Grandmother gave the book to Rekha. So please convert this in a subjective pronoun. So in subjective pronoun, we replace subject with pronoun. So here grandmother gave the book to Rekha. So grandmother is a subject. So we replace subjective pronoun by she. She gave the book to Rekha. Here we're talking about grandmother. That grandmother is a third person. So that is a third person. And third person, it is a girl. So we apply here she pronoun. She gave the book to Rekha. Okay. So now the objective pronoun. Objective pronoun is a pronoun that is used in the place of object. So here, grandmother gave the book to Rekha. So Rekha is a object. So grandmother gave the book to her. Right? They're talking about her because her is a objective pronoun. Okay? So we will ending our session here. In next session, we will talking about workbook exercise. Okay? Bye-bye. Take care.